The AP Bio exam is one of the toughest exams to pass. In this video, we're going to go over 5 simple steps that you can take to start writing effective AP Biology FRQs. If you like this video, make sure you hit this like and subscribe button so that you can get more AP Biology tips. In a follow-on video, we'll also go over 25 tips that you can take when it comes to tackling your free responses. So without further ado, let's get started. The first step when it comes to writing effective AP Biology free response questions is to understand and master the rubric. The easiest way to do this is to visit the College Board's past released exam site. In this site, they're going to provide breakdowns of all the scoring guidelines in the past few years. So you'll be able to see how points were allocated in certain problems, as you can see in this example displayed on the screen. Now, let's move on to step 2. The second step when it comes to writing effective AP Biology FRQs is to underline or circle any key word or phrase. The nice thing about the AP Biology exam is that the College Board actually tells you and signals to you how many points each question is worth through their bolded text. In other words, if there are 2 words bolded in the question, it means that this question is probably worth 2 points. Let's take a look at this example. Here you can see that there are a few words that we've highlighted, such as identify, make a claim, provide reasoning, and calculate. So what I can probably gather from this is that this question is worth at least 4 points. So one of our best taking tips that we can tell you is to create a system for yourself. Put a check mark or star each of these bolded words when you're answering your response. And the reason why is because this will make sure that you've actually addressed or at least attempted to address each part of the question. Now let's move on to step 3. The third step when it comes to writing effective AP Bio FRQs is to understand what the question is asking you and to identify the common directive words. What are directive words? Well, as you can see on the screen here, here are 9 of the most common AP Biology directive words. We call these question steps. What these do is they cue you in on what specifically you need to address in your response. Let's take a look at these 9 common AP Biology question steps. The first one is calculate, and what that means is that you're going to be asked to solve a problem. The second one is to compare. So this is where you're going to want to go over the similarities of 2 or more things. The third one is contrast. So this is the opposite of compare. You're going to show the differences between 2 or more things. The next one is to discuss, and this means that you're going to outline the pros as well as the cons to a topic, process, theory, or technique. The next one is describe. So this is the sort of question where you're going to be asked to characterize something. And then we have explain. This is where you need to demonstrate your ability to make something understandable. Next, we have identify. So if you're asked to identify something, this means to give a direct answer to the question. If you're asked to interpret something, this means that you need to analyze something critically or explain something that isn't clear to someone. And then finally, we have justify. So this is where you have to explain why something may happen. Stems like calculate, explain, and justify are usually associated with 2-point problems on AP Bio. So something that you want to notice is that these question stems are relatively open-ended. For example, we have describe, discuss, explain, interpret. So what this means is that you're going to need to give a more thorough response to the problem, right? So for example, if you're asked to explain why a certain result may occur from an experiment, you need to be exhaustively talking about the experimental design, right? You need to talk about these effective ways to measure dependent variables. Make sure that you're actually being thorough when it comes to these open-ended question stems. Don't make the mistake of providing single sentence responses when the test maker is expecting more from you, right? And so AP Biology students often lose 5 or more points when it comes to the first and second problems in the AP Bio FRQ section because they really just lack the specificity that the grader is looking for. Now that we've gone over the question stems, let's go into step 4. The 4th step is to make sure that you're being succinct in your FRQ. Now this is a very nuanced point when you think about it in relation to the prior tip. And the reason being is because you want to make sure that your AP Bio FRQ is not an English essay. Your reader does not need to know everything under the sun that you learned in your class. What they need to know is, what is your response to the question? One of the mistakes that students make is they might be asked to identify 4 properties of something, and instead they list 9. Guess what? The graders are only going to look at the first 4 you put down. So if you think that you're giving yourself some insurance when you're listing out more than what's being asked of you, you're incorrect here, and you want to make sure that you are actually just directly answering the question. So what are some principles that we can keep in mind when we're trying to be succinct in our answers? Well, the first one is to make sure that you're not just restating the question. This is unnecessary and is not going to score you any points. The second one is to make sure that you're writing in complete sentences. It is not on your grader to figure out what you're trying to say. So you can't just write a half-baked sentence and expect somebody to understand you. The third tip is, if you're doing a calculation, make sure you clearly identify your final answer. You can do this really simply by boxing your answer and showing your work. Now, this second point is really important. Make sure that you're showing your work if you're being asked to calculate something. There are 2 points typically awarded. 1 point is for actually having the right answer, and the second one is for showing your work. The next tip that we have when it comes to some principles is to make sure that you're just answering the question and then moving on. A common mistake that AP Bio students make is that they'll make a contradicting statement after they've already stated the right answer. So if there is a contradicting statement in your response, you can actually lose points. So this goes back to that point that I was saying. If they're asking you to list 4 or identify 4 things, don't give them 9. The fifth tip is to apply that prior tip when it comes to answering the question and then moving on to graphing as well. If the question is only asking you to plot something or to put data points on a graph, you should just do that. If the question is asking you to graph, draw a line or curve, don't do more than what is asked. Don't anticipate or infer something that is not being asked of you. Too often students will do this and then they'll end up losing points on their FRQ section. And then our sixth tip is that when it comes to graphing, make sure that you follow graphing conventions, right? This means that you want to make sure your chart is titled. You want to make sure your axes are labeled. You want to make sure that your scales are appropriate, that you don't have something going from 1 to 5 to 10 and so on, right? And make sure that you actually select the right graph type. So these sorts of fundamentals are really important to demonstrate to your grader. And the final tip that we have when it comes to being succinct in your AP Biology FRQ is to make sure that you're being mindful of your handwriting. Graders are readers too, and this means that even though they're not going to grade you on how good your handwriting is, if they can't decipher your chicken scratch, then it's going to be a problem. So be mindful of that and be considerate when you're crafting your response. A final tip that we're going to throw into the principles before we jump into step 5 is to make sure that you're closing the loop, right? Make sure that you're actually being complete in your answer. If the question asks you, for example, to state the direction that something is changing, you can't just say that something is changing. You have to say the direction that something is actually changing. This is a commonly requested piece of feedback that AP graders give teachers, is that students aren't closing the loop enough. So one of the easiest ways to do that is to remember the word because or therefore. This allows you to remember that you need to actually respond to the question. So now moving on to step 5, this last tip is to make sure that you practice, and then practice some more. The thing about mastering AP Bio FRQs is that it comes down to 2 things. The first one is knowing the rubric and how points are allocated, and the second one is actually learning how to craft responses that score you points on these rubrics. Too often, students will do one really well, but not the other. In other words, they will learn the rubric, but they won't have actually practiced enough, so they know in their head that they're going to get points based on certain things, but then they don't actually know how to put the two together to actually earn those points. So make sure that you are actually looking at the rubric and then pairing it with your practice, right? So see how long it took you to answer one of these questions. Pace yourself. Learn how effective you are at matching what the rubric is being asked of you. So after a few times of doing this, you're going to be more and more mindful of what the test maker is looking for, and that's going to build your confidence come test day. So those are our 5 tips when it comes to writing effective AP Biology FRQs. Here are 3 more resources that you can use as you start preparing for your exam. The first one is the College Board's past released exams. Like we said earlier, this is the best way that you can get some practice and exposure to the rubrics as well as the questions that you'll be asked. The second thing is our best review guide for AP Biology. This is a free resource that you can access on our blog and use as a study guide as you're preparing for the exam. The last one is Albert's review course, and what this provides for AP Biology is hundreds of practice questions, including FRQs, with exemplars of how students could have scored full points for those respective responses. So that'll be really helpful when you're trying to build your confidence and learn by doing. Lastly, make sure that you hit that subscribe button or that like button, because in our next video, we're going to go over the 25 tips that you should keep in mind when it comes to tackling the AP Biology FRQ section that we didn't go over in this video. So hope you enjoyed this video, and we'll see you next time.